All right, what is up, you guys? It's the Sandman, back at it again. I've optimized some of the recording stuff, so hopefully the video is going to be a lot less choppy than it was recently. I don't know why that's been happening, but, you know, hopefully fix the issue, man. But here we go. This is Tool, second song on the channel. I reacted to the incorrect version of Sober recently, guys. So sorry if I picked the wrong video for that. Hopefully I'll switch over to the live version and do a fresh reaction to that one. But this one is Stinkfist. Let's go. Okay. Huh. Uh-oh. Wow, that drums. Oh, so kick-ass main riff, man. This riff is very characteristic of Tool, I feel like. The kind of skippy feel where you go like boom, 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 boom. I've heard snippets of Pot, and I've heard of the Pot, and there's a very similar guitar riff. Sounds very similar. It's like dun 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 dun. So it's very similar to that, and I feel like I heard some bass licks, not the whole song, from Schism. I'm trying to think if there's similarities there, but yeah, and I love how it picks up. It basically boosts. It's like a boosted version of the riff in the pre-chorus, and the chorus kind of tones it down vocally a little bit. Yeah, I love the pre-chorus a lot. I love the vocal styles, that the stylistic choices that he uses there, where it's kind of unpredictable, but it's also very it's like great for like storytelling effect, you know. I hard to explain, but I'll get to the next in the next one. But yeah, and I like this chorus riff right here. A lot of great drumming. Here we go. Right there. Yeah, that last part, to know I'm alive. I love how it fades down, it like descends down into madness once the rest of these instruments kick in and this new verse, this new riff change happens. That was a part I was really loved in that pre-chorus, man. Dream. Yeah! Let's go! Crazy. Man, my goodness. See, I'm playing this whole part back. I'm sorry. Oh, man. I had to stop at that drum fill. I was going to talk about it. I was going to talk about the whole bridge section, the instrumental interlude. I shouldn't stop here. Let's play it whole back again. It's just amazing. I'll get to it at the end. Oh, man. So good. Wow, man. Song's got a lot of twists and turns in it. The second half of the song was a real musical experience, man. There is nothing that I've heard that can compare that's a bit bold of a statement, but there's very few things that I've heard just on first listen in terms of like instrumental sections that really like sucked me into it as much as this did. Yeah, so you guys know my favorite part of the song, man. It's that whole instrumental interlude into that, like, bridge right before the outro. Crazy. And the way he sings that, something kind of sad about, you know what I mean? When he starts singing that, you can feel the emotion in his voice. You know, beforehand, there was a really good, like, when you hear the lyrics before, like, that kind of radio effect. I like the effect there because it's like a voice inside your head. It makes you think of, like, inner voices inside of you. Yeah, and you see in this first verse, the drum pattern is just constant. It's just a constant drum pattern. And then the variations keep picking up as the song goes on. They're so good at building up a song, like... It's not like reuse, recycle, then go to straight line or linear, reuse, recycle, you know, go keep going. These guys like keep building throughout the whole song, man. So awesome. There we go. And I love this pre-chorus. And there's a lot of jarring sounds in this whole song. You have like the raking, there's like this rake effect either on guitar or the bass. Like it's kind of like a palm mute, but it's like an emphasized palm mute. Not so much right now, but later on. But here you can even hear the openness of the chords when he's the upstroke. Like there's this ringing sound. So they introduce that a lot. That's one thing I also noticed about the last song when a couple of the other Tool musical stuff that I picked up on. Yeah. And here's the first part of like real drummed complexity. Rhythmic real complexity happens here, the first part. And I don't know if the cymbals are different now, the hits on the hi-hat, but still fairly steady. And you could hear, you can hear a subtle pickup in the intensity and even this guitar riff in the back. You could just slightly hear it. It happens very soon. You can hear just, it goes up a notch a little bit. Not yet. It's like now it's like instead of dun dun dun, dun it's like dun 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 dun, 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 dun. Very, very subtle. Awesome. I mean these little things you notice them subconsciously, but wow. Really great stuff. Let's go to this instrumental section, man. Each new layer that was introduced here just blew my mind. Let's go. Oh, this bass lick. This bass lick is absolutely infectious. An example of that. Yeah, I love the sound of this. It's rhythmically, it's similar to the main riff, but it's just different. It's just this really ethereal sound, really cool ethereal sound to it. One second, I gotta charge this. I don't want this footage to leave, man. This is too good. All right. Ooh, we're back in business. Okay. Yeah, and then, of course, the outro's there, so, yeah, man, awesome stuff. Awesome song. I love the theme behind the song, too. It's, like, desensitization. There's, like, some very, kind of, like, obscene metaphor, right, to, you know, certain acts. You guys know what I'm talking about. But, I like it because there's this one thing that makes me think it's like a metaphor, and that is knuckle deep inside the borderline. So the borderline is just basically this, it's like a perverse, like, you know, talking about the limits, right? Society. I read up somewhere that this might be about like desensitized technology, over reliance on technology. I wonder if they're what the music video is about. That might give another hint into it. Technology dependence, letting people control you, society, letting people in, like, kind of interfere upon your, like, human rights and things like that. And there's a lot of things it could be about, but it's just telling you, convincing you that it's okay, this is the right way to do things, because it's all about love, or it's all about this, like, it's all for a good purpose, but really it's just not, you know. And it's a very, like, I love the helplessness of that after the instrumental section versus just like a reflection, and just trying to convince you, right? I'm convincing you this is okay beforehand, like the first two verses, and then you have like that instrumental thing going on, and then you have like the kind of, oh my goodness, this is reality, and it's like the reflection of reality and how it is. So I like it a lot. And then the end is crazy. The end is crazy. I'll keep digging until I feel something. Elbow deep inside, no, show me that you love me. So it's like you keep digging until you feel like you go through. So maybe it's more so about like self-indulgence, and you get so desensitized to whatever it may be, like a lot of things in life, you know what I mean? If you want to be literal about it, could be, you know, sexual stuff, could be drugs, could be food, you know, all sorts of things. Maybe not food, that's probably not as powerful, but you know, a bunch of things, just how you live life and what you rely on, you know, what you indulge yourself in and get desensitized to. I really love the lyrics a lot, and I'm really curious also, I'll have to look into this, how they write their drum parts, because some of the stuff that he comes up with is just very complex, man. Not so much this song even as even like other songs, I would guess, but just some of the stuff is just so nuanced. You just have to think, like, is some of this, like, improvised over, like, the musical track, or is he just grooving, and he comes up with a steady groove, and he plays variations off of it in, like, new takes, and then you put those new takes in there after he gets the standard bass line down, he knows what he's doing already. Whatever it is, I don't know, but I'd love to find out. So, awesome stuff. Stinkfist, great track, man. Amazing. It's the Sandman checking out. Peace.